actually, I had to surprise you because you didn't give me your new phone number yet.
Your phone won't be hooked up till Monday.
Sleepless in Seattle, Chinese food. Looks like you're setting yourself up for a good cry. How are you?
I'm fine. How'd you find me?
Kevin,
that was swell of him. He introduced you to Deborah while he was at it?
No, is she why,
Yep, that's his new roommate as of Saturday.
What happened? I thought you and Kevin were really...
Yeah, I did too. I even bought a subscription to Bride Magazine.
A subscription? No one does that.
Well, if you ever read one of these and you read all the information and etiquette, you'll want to elope.
Yeah, but not with the wrong guy.
No.
Where did Kevin meet this girl?
I met her at work. She came from Baltimore 3 months ago. I actually just met her on Saturday when I caught her with Kevin. No. Kitchen. Just leave her alone.
Oh, I'm sorry. I mean, about Kevin. I'm really sorry.
Don't feel sorry. It's my own fault. I should have seen it coming.
Well, why didn't you tell me?
I was looking for a place to live. I had to move all my stuff. And quite frankly, I didn't want to hear, "I told you so."
From me?
From you.
Wow. My only sister has an almost fiancé cheat on her. You have to move to this small apartment in this bad neighborhood and I'm going to say I told you so?
And you made it quite clear you didn't approve of us living together.
Well, maybe, but we care what happens to you. Why didn't you call? We could have helped you move.
And I paid some guys at work to do it.
Why? You know Bill and I have a truck. We would love to help you move.
I just wanted to get out of there as quick as I could. I guess I probably should have called you.
At least you're not alone.
Oh, it sure feels like I am. Big sister sits back, watches me fall smack on my face, and then she swoops in to pick up all the pieces when my life falls apart.
That's not fair.
Well, unfair is being dumped by somebody who says they love you, and then not being there for you when they said they would be.
Well, that's Kevin, not me.
Well, Kevin's not the first.
Well, so you've dated a lot of dysfunctional guys.
I'm not just talking about guys here, Betsy. I'm talking about our family.
Look, I know you're really hurting right now, and you think the whole world's against you, but your family's not. I'm not.
You may not be for me, but you're certainly... You may not be against me, but you're certainly not for me.
Well, what does that mean?
Well, you never stopped by with pizza when I was living with Kevin. In fact, I don't think you ever even stopped by.
Well, it was awkward.
Why?
It just was.
Well, I'm sorry it was awkward. But I just don't feel like I can count on anyone.
Well, what about Mom?
Mom is your buddy. You are the one with the husband and the house and the little kids. Mom is so into that grandma role. She wants to get the little grape juice off the collar and make the little mittens for Amy so she doesn't scratch her chicken pox. If I need a pair of pants hemmed, she's right there. But when my life is falling apart, not so much.
Well, maybe you need to let us know. Maybe you need to tell us.
I can't.
You won't?
I have, but it just blows up in my face.
What are you talking about?
Do you know the one thing that I shared with you when that one thing was? I'll tell you. It was 2 years ago from this past January, and I told you I was thinking about seeing a counselor. And so then you told Mom, and of course Mom tells Dad because she tells him everything. And the next thing I know, the whole family's involved in this. And then I get a call from Pastor Mike at work that says your parents are so concerned about you. Do you know how embarrassed and angry I was?
Okay, so I made one mistake.
Oh no, it's not one mistake. It's been happening my whole life. Every time I share something with you, you just blow it off. Do you know what the one thing in my life that I wanted to do?
Get married?
Funny, now you sound just like Mom. No, I told you I wanted to be an actress.
Oh, that.
No, don't owe that. That was what I wanted to do. That was my dream. You know, whether it was ridiculous, whether I could do it, whether I couldn't do it, it doesn't matter. That's what I wanted to do. You know, I played Anita in West Side Story, and I was good. No, you know, actually, I was very good. Even the newspaper said so. But did Mom and Dad show up? Did you show up? No. Nobody from the family even came to support me.
Well, Mom didn't want you to fall into a dead-end career.
Well, don't worry, she didn't.
Well, I didn't either.
Oh, yeah. You know, look, I'm just feeling really tired.
Well, okay, I guess I can go. I'll call you when you call me when you get your new phone number.
All right.
Bye.
Pepperoni? I have only been a vegetarian for over 2 years. Go find something else to eat here.